We're heading down to Louisiana to revisit a small town with a huge heart. Steel Magnolias is a 1989 film based on the stage play from 87. Always suggested that the meaning of the title alludes to the fact that the leading ladies are both beautifully delicate as a flower, yet tough as steel. Laughter through tears is my favorite emotion. Whew, this movie, full of love, affection, small town antics, and a tight-knit group of friends that bring you into Truvy's beauty parlor and make you one of their own.
Jackson comes from a good old Southern family with good old Southern values. Either shoot it, stuff it, or marry it.
I'm your host, Nostalgic Nick, and today we're catching up with possibly the best core group of female actresses of all time. If you enjoy our throwback, be sure to give it a thumbs up for us and subscribe to the channel so you never miss a memory. Now let's pop on over to the salon. Dolly Parton. Truvy Jones is the big-haired beautician who has lived in town all her life, semi-happily married to Spud Jones, played by playwright Sam Shepard. Truvy is vivacious and full of town gossip, with the most successful shop in town, because, quote,
"There is no such thing as natural beauty."
It's all about the effort, and Dolly gave hers.
Oh, I can see that.
Yet, after a poor take, director Herbert Ross reprimanded Dolly and asked if she could act. She replied, quote, "No, but it's your job to make me look like I can." Incredible. Where to begin with Dolly? By 13 years old, she was already recording on a small label and appearing at the Grand Ole Opry. At 20, Dolly married Carl Dean, who ran an asphalt paving business, and the two have been happily married ever since. The following year, Porter Wagner hired her to begin appearing on his program, and after 7 years of wildly popular duets, Dolly embarked on her solo career. And from number one hits like Joshua,
Joshua!
To Jolene. Dolly was now shaping the 1970s soundtrack. Her first film role was in 1980, co-starring with Jane Fonda and Lily Tomlin in 9 to 5. Dolly wrote and recorded the film's title song, which, when released, won 2 Grammy Awards for the singer-actress. The 80s brought Steel Magnolias, as well as The Best Little Whorehouse in Texas, co-starring with Burt Reynolds. Dolly is also a business titan. The Dollywood Foundation has several ventures, highlighted by Dollywood, located near Knoxville. The foundation also contributes to several charitable organizations, including the American Red Cross and HIV/AIDS-related charities. Today, Dolly is 75 years old and deserves every accolade, even if she won't accept. In response to a 2021 proposal to erect a statue of Parton in Tennessee, she responded, quote, "Given all that is going on in the world, I don't think putting me on a pedestal is appropriate at this time. Certainly a hero in my eyes." Sally Field. Malin Eatonton is a social worker and mom of the century, literally giving her organ to her daughter Shelby to try and save her life. Watching Malin try to come to terms with losing her only daughter is heart-wrenching, and Sally puts in one of the best performances ever. The funeral aftermath is painfully real. Field began acting in 1962, and by 65 she had her own title role in the series Gidget. However, it was her 1967 role as Sister Bertrand, aka the Flying Nun, that really made Sally a household favorite. She broke into cinemas everywhere as Carrie, co-starring with Burt Reynolds, in Smokey and the Bandit and its sequel.
Think of it as a wedding posse in search of a bride. Do you understand that, cowboy?
From 76 to 82, Field had a relationship with Burt Reynolds during the time they co-starred in 4 films together. Then 1979's titular role as Norma Rae gave Sally her first Academy Award nomination and victory. She'd win again in 1984 for Places in the Heart.
"And I can't deny the fact that you like me right now. You like me."
Heading into the 90s, a personal favorite is certainly her work with Robin Williams in the outrageously funny Mrs. Doubtfire. Today, she is 74 years old and still very active. She's currently a part of the 2020 AMC show, Dispatches from Elsewhere, and we will always be a fan. Tom Skerritt. Drum Eatonton is Malin's husband, straightforward and simple-minded. Whether he's recklessly shooting blanks at birds, or deaf from said bullets trying to give his daughter away.
It's time!
Basically, he is his motto, never deal with the wife. Tom Skerritt became well-known in Hollywood for 1970s film MASH, alongside Donald Sutherland and Elliot Gould. Then 1979's creepy sci-fi epic Alien continued Skerritt's string of box office hits. And one of his best-known roles was 1986's Top Gun. For more on Tom, and the other Tom too, check out our deep dive into that Tony Scott-directed action flick after this. Shirley MacLaine. Miss Weezer is the grouchy and feared elder of the town, and Clarice's best friend.
I'm not crazy, Malin. I've just been in a very bad mood for 40 years.
Man, when Weezer comes marching up with her huge Clifford-sized dog barking away, the chemistry between her and Drum is outrageously mean and downright hysterical. Although she and Tom Skerritt played antagonists, in 1976 they played a married couple in The Turning Point, coincidentally also directed by Herbert Ross. And Shirley sure had the chops for Weezer. Her brother's not a bad actor either. Warren Beatty is 3 years younger than Shirley, whose professional career began in 1955, being directed by the legendary Alfred Hitchcock in The Trouble with Harry. 3 years later, she co-starred with Frank Sinatra in Some Came Running and received her first Oscar nom. And 1960 brought possibly her best work alongside Jack Lemmon in The Apartment, once again nominated for Best Actress. She wouldn't take home the trophy until her sixth nomination for 1983's Terms of Endearment. More recently, it was fun seeing her take on the iconic role of Endora in the 2005 reboot attempt of Bewitched. Today, she's in her late 80s and still at it. We last saw her in the 2019 Disney Plus Christmas original Noelle. Aside from her acting, she has also written a number of books on metaphysics, spirituality, and reincarnation. Daryl Hannah. There's a story there. Valedictorian of her beauty class, Anel is the newbie in town and new apprentice to Truvy. We watch Anel become a confident member of society, and her growth is beautiful. Daryl Hannah got her start in 1978, but really got her footing in 82, starring as the violent and acrobatic replicant in Ridley Scott's classic Blade Runner. 2 years later, she got possibly her best known role, alongside Tom Hanks as the mermaid in Splash. Her film career has never let up, revitalizing it in the 2000s in Quentin Tarantino's Kill Bill Volumes 1 and 2.
Dying in our sleep is a luxury that our kind is rarely afforded.
Most recently, she starred in the Netflix series Sense8 for both seasons. Today, she is 60 years old, and aside from acting, she is also a staunch political activist, often protesting various political policies that go against the ability to environmentally sustain. And we should probably trust the mermaid when it comes to environmental issues. Olympia Dukakis. Well, you know what they say. If you don't have anything nice to say about anybody, come sit by me. Clarie Belcher is the town's former first lady and a vital member of the friend group. She was affluent and kind and got Malin out of her post-funeral crying spell by suggesting she sock Weezer in the face.
Knock her lights out, Malin!
Let go of me!
Shoulda took her up on it. I know Drum would've. Olympia Dukakis' career began in 1962, but took off in the 80s, thanks to an Academy Award-winning role in 1987's Moonstruck. She followed that with Steel Magnolias, and then played the principal in 1995's Mr. Holland's Opus. Olympia works consistently. In 1993, she starred in the miniseries Tales of the City, which has regrouped multiple times for more installments, most recently 2019's 10 episodes for Netflix. Today, Olympia is 89 years old and a hardcore New Yorker. She's also released her best-selling autobiography, Ask Me Again Tomorrow, A Life in Progress. Julia Roberts. Shelby is Malin's eldest child and nurse, whose wedding sets the stage for the film. She sadly suffers from type 1 diabetes, and her health troubles plague our story. The first diabetic episode in that beauty salon is difficult to watch, and Julia was quite remarkable. Roberts' first big feature role was in 1988 for the film Mystic Pizza. She followed that with her Shelby Eatonton, and Hollywood now had a new top 5 superstar on their hands. She sparked the 90s 90s off with Pretty Woman, opposite Richard Gere.
You work on commission, right?
Yes. Big mistake. Big. Huge.
And bested that one with her first of the 2000s, winning an Oscar for The True Story of Aaron Brockovich. Robert and her husband, cameraman Daniel Moder, met on the set of their film The Mexican in 2000, and the couple have three children together. Today, she is 53 years old, and just as active and wonderful as ever, most recently in the 2018 Amazon series Homecoming. What a phenomenal cast! It's thrilling to watch the seasoned talents of Sally Field and Shirley MacLaine welcome such incredible newcomers as Julia Roberts and Daryl Hannah. What a film. So tell us, who was your favorite character from Steel Magnolias? Has anyone seen a production of the original stage play? Well, let us know in the comments below. We read everyone. And while you're there, drop another film that you think we should dive into next. And don't forget to like and subscribe to continue the growth of our garden of videos. From all of us here at Do You Remember, thanks so much for watching.